Good day. Today, I'm happy to let you know our Jumper T16 now supports more receiver protocols. And that includes the new FrSky ACCST D16 version 2.1 protocol used on both the XSR and R-XSR FrSky receivers. Oh yeah! A big thanks to the multi-protocol devs for making that happen. Two other protocols which our Jumper T16 also now support are the Skyartec and FrSky L, which is used for the FrSky L9R long-range receiver. Today, I'll be focusing on the ACCST D16 protocol. So what does this mean for you? Well, in this video, I previously described some incompatibility issues between FrSky receiver firmware and our Jumper T16 and provided various options as a workaround to include buying non-FrSky receivers. Now, by the end of this video, you'll know how to use genuine FrSky XSR and R-XSR receivers running version 2.1 firmware with your Jumper T16. I'll show you how to make that happen in just a few quick steps. Today I'm going to update our multi-module firmware. I'll update a receiver with ACCST D16 2.1 firmware, only because I currently don't have one with it installed, so that'll be a little bonus for you. And I'll bind the receiver with a new firmware to our Jumper T16. Sound good? Then please, share this video with your friends so that they can take advantage of these good features too. Give it a thumbs up below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff.
To update the firmware on our Jumper T16 multi-module, the first thing we have to do is find the latest firmware and download it. To do that, we go to this multi-module.org, which is Mr. Ben Lai's site. He's done an outstanding job of making it very simple and easy for us. This is also where you can donate to the multi-module project devs through PayPal to support further development of all these nice features that Mr. Ben Lai and Pascal Langer and the multi-module development team have come up with for us. To download the firmware, we go to Firmware Updates. Keep in mind the multi-module firmware is not the same as the radio firmware or the operating system firmware within your Jumper T16, which is OpenTX. And this firmware, the multi-module firmware, must be updated separately. If you're still a little bit fuzzy on the differences or how they interact with each other, I've got a video on that which you can go ahead and check out here. And I'll also include in the links in the video description below. Step one is to download the appropriate firmware. So we're going to go to the firmware files. We're going to click here, which takes us to this multi-module firmware downloads. And you just have some drop-down menus here, which you can select the options for the particular transmitter and multi-module that you're using. So in this case, I'm going to select Jumper T16 Pro internal module, STEM32, OpenTX, channel order. I'm going to select AETR. There's a section on channel order over on one of the previous pages of a site. If you need further explanation on what channel order to select for your particular circumstance, then you can go to this previous page on a site and read up on that. Telemetry inversion, choose inverted for external modules or not inverted for internal modules. Since I have an internal module, I'm going to choose not inverted, which it defaults to. And the latest stable version comes up here, 13091. Which it automatically loads here. So this is the file that we want to download for my particular case in the AETR no INV version for my multi-module on my Jumper T16 Pro with an internal module. We're going to click on this and download it. Downloads over here. Then I'm going to copy and paste this file to a folder which I've previously made on my hard drive under DIY multi-protocol TX module. Paste. And now that it's on my hard drive, I just need to copy and paste this to my SD card and my Jumper T16. We'll do that next. So our next step is to get the file which we just downloaded from Ben Lai's site onto our SD card of our Jumper T16. And there's a couple ways you can do that. You can either take the SD card out of the T16 and use an adapter, or hold these two trim tabs together and press the power key. And you'll see the lights stops on one here. And from there, we're going to plug this into the computer using the USB cable. And you can see it says USB connected. And then what I've done is I've got two screens opened up. One for the file here, which we've downloaded into the folder which I previously made on my hard drive. And the second window is because our SD card contents are now showing up over here on my drive D. Your drive designation may be different. For me, it's showing up on drive D. So I'm going to go to my firmware folder on my SD card. This is my SD card contents right here. I'm going to go to my firmware folder on my SD card contents, and this is where I stored previous versions for my multi-module firmware here. So I'm going to take this file and I'm going to copy and paste it onto the firmware folder within my Jumper T16 SD card. So I'm going to paste, and there it is. Now I've got it in two locations. If I wanted to, I could actually delete it from my hard drive on my computer, since I've already got it on the SD card of my Jumper T16. For now, that's irrelevant. We've accomplished what we wanted to by moving the file to the SD card of our Jumper T16. And that's a good thing. Next, we're going to take that file from our SD card and flash our internal multi-module.
Okay, to flash our internal multi-module, we disconnect the transmitter from the computer by disconnecting the USB cable, and we scroll to exit. And it automatically turns on, and we go to our radio setup menu page to our SD card contents, and here we see our firmware folder, so we scroll down to there, short click on that, and it brings up the contents within the firmware folder of our SD card. These are the previous versions of the multi-module firmware that I had on here, and this 91 is the latest version, which we just downloaded and copied over to our SD card. So I'm going to click on that, scroll down, click on that, and we have options which show up. We can flash internal multi, flash external multi, or any of these other three. Since I've got an internal multi-module on my Jumper T16, I'm going to flash internal multi by just pressing on the scroll wheel. Device reset. And it's writing. It's writing this file, version 13091, to our multi-module. Flash successful, and that's a good thing.
Okay, in order for me to demonstrate that a FrSky R-XSR or XSR receiver with version 2.1 ACCST D16 firmware on it works with our Jumper T16, I actually need to have one, which I don't, so I'm going to make one. I do have an R-XSR. It does not have version 2.1 firmware on it, so we're going to update it with version 2.1 firmware. If you're already familiar with how to update receiver firmware using your Jumper T16, go ahead and use the hyperlink table of contents to skip to the next section. If you want a refresher or you're not familiar with how to do this step, stick around. To get the correct firmware on our R-XSR, we need to go to this site, click on R-XSR, go to ACC D16 firmware. We don't want access firmware, we want the ACC D16 firmware. And we see that the latest version is ACC D16 version 2.1. That's what we want. We're going to download it, and it's going to download over here, at which point I am going to cut and paste this to a folder which I previously saved on my hard drive. Firmware R-XSR, paste, extract here, and it's going to make a new folder for me, which means that I can delete this one. And I'm going to double click on this folder and find the correct version for my receiver. We have F-port files, we have an LBT file, and we have an FCC file. I'm not using F-port, I don't use LBT. Since I'm in North America, I use the FCC file. So what I'm going to do here is copy this, and I'm just going to paste it to our SD card. To do that, we use the exact same process that we did previously for moving our multi-module firmware to our SD card by connecting the transmitter to the computer. Since we've already done that, it's the exact same process. I'm going to save some time and not repeat it.
Okay, now that we've got our D16 version 2.1 firmware on our SD card inside the transmitter, right now it's not doing us any good. We need to get it on our receiver. To do that, we're going to use one of these wiring harnesses with the servo cable on the end. I've got three of them here because I wanted to show you the difference. This is the servo cable wiring harness that actually comes with most of your receivers. And with this black servo cable end, the wires are in this order: yellow, red, black, or signal, power, ground. We're not going to do that. The reason being is we're going to be using these pins inside the module bay of our T16. Specifically these bottom pins. This bottom pin is going to be signal, the next pin up from that is going to be ground, and the next pin up from that is going to be power. So we want ground
to be in our middle servo connector. Currently, with the servo cable that comes with most receivers, the power is in the middle, not the ground. So we're going to use this servo cable where I actually switched the power and ground wires inside the servo cable. To do that, all you need to do is there's these little tabs just behind these metal contacts. You lift them up, pull the wire out, stick them back in. So on this cable, I just swapped the order of the power and the ground. I didn't have to do any changes to this end of the wiring harness for the RXSR. However, if you're going to update your firmware using your Jumper T16 for the Jumper R1 receiver, then you do need to swap wires in this connector. Instead of ground, power, signal right next to each other, we have ground, power, skip a hole, and then signal. So all you have to do from the regular servo cable, besides swapping the ground and the power on the servo connector for the R1 receiver, in addition to doing that, you need to take this yellow signal wire out, move it over one space, and reinsert it. And once again, the way you do that is by lifting one of these little tabs, pull the yellow wire out, lift the tab up on the next one over, stick the yellow wire in, and pat the tab down to make it secure. So this wiring harness is for the Jumper R1. This is what normally comes in your receiver package, and this is the cable that we swap the wires on for our R-XSR in order to update it using the external module bay in our Jumper T16. So let's go ahead and do that now. And I'm going to insert this with the signal wire at the bottom, yellow at the bottom, into these bottom three pins of our Jumper T16. Make sure it's secure. And then I'm taking our R-XSR receiver that's got the older version D16 firmware on it. I'm going to update it by connecting the other wire, the other end of the wiring harness, to it. I'll stick it down there so you can see the LEDs flash. We're going to press and hold sys to get to the radio setup menu page. We're going to go to firmware. Click on firmware, and hopefully we find our 2.1 R-XSR firmware, which we do, because that's where we placed it on our SD card. So I'm going to scroll down to the R-XSR 2.1 firmware. If you're going to update your Jumper R1 receiver with ACCST 2.1 firmware, for some reason, I'm not necessarily recommending this or suggesting it. However, if you do so, then to update your Jumper R1 receiver, you will need the XSR firmware, not the R-XSR. I'm going to be using the R-XSR to update our R-XSR receiver. For the Jumper R1, you would need the XSR firmware. But since we're doing the R-XSR, I'm going to scroll down to R-XSR, short press on that, and this submenu pops up. And we have these options once again. Previously, to update our internal multi-protocol module, we used flash internal module. That made sense. However, for this case, we're not going to do that. We're not going to flash our internal multi-module with the receiver firmware. That would be a bad thing. What we want to do is instead, since our receiver is connected to the external module bay, we're going to flash external module. So we're going to scroll down to external module, press enter, device reset. It's writing, and you see the lights, the LEDs pop up, green light steady pretty much, red light flashing slowly. It's specifically writing the RXSR ACCST 2.1 FCC firmware to our FrSky R-XSR receiver. And as it completes, you should see the LEDs on the receiver go out. LEDs are out. Screen goes blank. Raise the throttle to get the screen back. And our flash has been successful. We press enter. And that's a good thing. Now all we need to do is connect our receiver up to our quadcopter and bind it to the internal module of our Jumper T16. Let's do that.
Now, before we attempt to bind our receiver with a new version 2.1 ACCST protocol on it, we go to Pascal Langer's github.com site at this URL, and we go to protocol details. Underneath protocol details, it says available protocol table of contents listed alphabetically. He's got this arranged nicely for us. So we know that it's using some sort of FrSky protocol. So we go down to FrSky, FrSky, and here he's got FrSky D, which is for D8 mode, FrSky L for LR12 and LR12-6 channel, FrSky R9, FrSky V, let's take a look at what that is, for these types of receivers. And then we've got FrSky X, X2, and RX. So let's take a look at those. FrSky X is for 16 channel, 8 channel, EU16, and EU8, and something called cloned, which I'm not going to get into in this video. So let's take a look at FrSky X. The models which this supports are FrSky version 1.xx receivers. The protocol is also known as D16 version 1 FCC and LBT. That's not what we want because we just uploaded version 2, not version 1. Let's take a look at FrSky X2. 16 channel, 8 channel, 16 EU, 8 channel EU, and this clone thing again. Under FrSky X2, it states that it's the same as FrSky X, but for D16 version 2.1 FCC and LBT firmware. D16 version 2.1. This is not D8, this is D16 version 2.1. So that's what we want for a receiver. We want the FrSky X2 protocol. So with that in mind, that's what we're going to look for, the FrSky X2 protocol in our modes when we go to bind the receiver to our multi-module. So let's go ahead and take a look for that.
All right, in order for us to bind our genuine FrSky R-XSR receiver with a D16 version 2.1 firmware on it to our Jumper T16, we're going to go to our model setup menu, and we're going to scroll up to where it says bind, just right there, just above that. We normally had FrSky D16 selected. However, with our version 2.1 firmware on it, with our updated internal multi-protocol module firmware, we're going to change this and look for FrSky X2. So let's go ahead and do that by clicking here and scrolling through the various protocols. Some of these protocols have auto-binding on them, and you'll hear it beeping. We're looking for FrSky X2. Not FrSky RX. There's FrSky X2. That's the one we want. We're going to click our scroll wheel, then we're going to scroll down to bind. I'm going to keep my receiver number at 0 and scroll over to bind. Now for the RXSR, the way you bind it is, while you get into bind mode on your transmitter, you depress and hold the bind button while simultaneously powering up the quadcopter and receiver. So let's go ahead and do that. Put the transmitter in bind and power the receiver. And we've got a steady blue light and a flashing red light. And then the green light. I'm gonna exit out of there, lift up on the bind button, and power cycle the receiver. Unplug the battery, plug it back in. And now we see we've got a steady green light and a steady blue light, and we're going to check to see if the RXSR with the version 2.1 firmware is actually bound. It's on FrSky X2, which is the version 2.1 firmware, and to verify that it's actually bound, I'm going to activate my beeper switch. And since we don't have any props on the quadcopter, all of our props are off as normal when we're working on it inside, I'm going to arm the quad and see if the motors spin. Which they are. And our launch mode.
Launch mode activated. Ready to launch.
As you can see, our genuine FrSky R-XSR receiver with a version 2.1 D16 firmware on it is now bound to our Jumper T16. And that's a good thing. Let's take her out for a spin. So that's an overview of a new receiver protocol supported with the latest multi-module firmware update for our Jumper T16, how to update the multi-module, a quick review of how to update a receiver's firmware using the Jumper T16, and a demonstration showing the Jumper T16 now works with ACCST D16 version 2.1. I hope you found it useful. For more free resources and to start your journey to better FPV with a Fast Track FPV course, head on over to my site at tmacfpv.com. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.